So now we will take some of the questions from the exercise 1B for your reference. So here the first question which I have taken is talking about the verifying the given condition. Here there is a condition where it says A plus B inside the bracket plus C. That means it is the rearrangement or the association which is taking place. Now the values of A, B and C is given to you and you have to find out whether the two given conditions are equal or not. Clear? So let's take the first condition, A plus B in the bracket plus C. So I will substitute the value of A. It is minus 1 upon 5 plus minus 5 upon 7 plus minus 1 upon 4. So we are going to solve this. Here, minus 1 upon 5 minus 5 upon 7 plus minus 1 upon 4. So here I will take the LCM 35, then minus 1 into 7 minus 5 into 5 inside the bracket plus minus 1 upon 4. Clear? Now let's solve. 7 ones are 7 minus 7 minus 25 upon 35. Okay, minus 7 minus 25 upon 35 inside the bracket plus minus 1 upon 4. So 7 and 5 12, 1 carry 3. So this becomes minus 32 upon 35 plus 1 upon 4. So to solve this further, what we will do? Minus 32 upon 35 plus minus 1 upon 4. Clear? Now let's solve this. Again, it will be 35 the LCM, minus 32 as it is. Now what is common between 35 and 4? That we will calculate through LCM. 35, 2, 2, 35, 1. 5 is 7, 1. 7 is 1 and 1. 5, 3 is 5, 7 is 35. 35 into 2 is 70. 70 into 2 is 2, 0 is 0. 2, 7 is 14. So what is your answer of the LCM of 35 and 4 is 35 into 4 because they are the different numbers, right? So what we have calculated here, let's see quickly. 2 2s are 4, 4 5s are 20, 27s are 140. So here you will write minus 1 into 35. Clear? Because minus 32 plus minus 35 upon 140. Clear? So when are you dividing 140? It goes 35 times. Clear? So minus 32 minus 35 upon 140 will give you 5 and 2, 7, 3 and 3, 6, minus 67 upon 140. So let's keep it for a record here because we will be solving the next condition now. Okay, the next condition is A plus B plus C. On substituting the value, minus 1 upon 5 plus minus 5 upon 7 plus minus 1 upon 4. Clear? Now, let's solve. Minus 1 upon 5 as it is plus 7 and 4, 28
Clear? Now here minus 5 into 4 plus minus 1 into 7. Inside the bracket, minus 1 upon 5 plus minus 20 minus 7 upon 28. Then again, minus 1 upon 5 plus minus 27 upon 28. Now, we will again take the LCM of the 2.
So, now, the next which we are left over are minus 1 upon 5 plus minus 27 upon 28. So, let's take the LCM of the 2. Before that, minus 1 upon 5 minus 27 upon 28. So, here it is, the LCM of 28 and 5 comes to be 140 again. Okay, so here when I divide 140 by 5, I get 28. So, 1 into 28 minus, when I divide 140 by 28, it goes 5 times. So, 27 into 5. So, this comes minus 28 upon 140. Here 5 7s are 35, 3 carry, 5 2s are 10 and 3 30, minus 135. So when we add the 2, 8 and 5 13, 1 carry, 4 and 2 6, 163. Now when we compare the LHS and RHS, minus 67 upon 140 and minus 163 upon 140, they are not coming same. That means they are not equal. So LHS is not equal to RHS. Now let's take the other question of verification. Okay. In this verification, you have to tell whether A plus B is equal to B plus A or not. See, minus 3 upon 11 plus minus 4 upon 7 is equal to minus 4 upon 7 plus minus 3 upon 11. So, we will take first the LHS. 11 and 7, 77. Minus 3 into 7, minus 4 into 11. Equals to, again, 77. Minus 4 into 11, minus 3 into 7. Minus 3 into 7 is minus 21. Here, 44 upon 77. Here also, minus 4 into 11, minus 44, minus 3 into 7 is what? 21 upon 77. So, this gives you 4 and 1, 5. 4 and 2, 6. 65 upon 77 equals to, again, 65 upon 77. Hence, our LHS is equal to RHS. So, this condition is proved that A plus B is equal to B plus A. Now, let's move to the further examples. So, now let's take some more questions of the exercise 1B. So, the other question which I'll be taking is rearrange and solve the following. So, here is your question in which it is saying that you have to rearrange minus 6 minus 5 upon 3 plus 0 plus 3 upon 27 plus 5 upon 9. So, rearrangement means we have to rearrange. So, let's take 0 at the first plus minus 6 minus 5 upon 3. I will make group of these two, then 3 upon 27 plus 5 upon 9,
again group of these two. Then we will solve this. Okay. Now 0 will come as it is, plus 3 will be your LCM, then minus 6 into 3 minus 5. Okay. What I have done here, I have rearranged the rational numbers. The rearrangement of the rational numbers has to be done first. Then you are supposed to solve the given question. So what I did, I took 0 outside, arranged the two negative numbers in one bracket, and I arranged the two positive numbers in the other bracket. Now I will be taking the LCM separately of the two groups of negative and positive rational numbers, and then I will be solving them. Okay, so here in the first case I have taken the LCM 3. Here it is 1. So when I divide 3 by 1, it goes 3 times, and here that is why I have multiplied minus 6 by 3. Next is minus 5, plus again 27 will be the LCM. Okay, now 3 will be as it is, plus 5 into 3, because when you divide 27 by 9, it goes 3 times, right? Now let's see, 0 plus minus 6 into 3 is minus 18 minus 5 upon 3, clear? Now plus 3 plus 5 into 3, that is 15 upon 27, clear? Now here, when I have multiplied this, minus 18 and minus 3 comes to be minus 23 upon 3 plus 3 upon 15, 18 upon 27. Now this I will be reducing. Okay, this I will be reducing. So how it will be reduced? It will be reduced 2s and 3s. I have divided it by 9. So 0 plus minus 23 upon 3 plus 2 upon 3. Okay. So let's see. Minus 23 upon 3 plus 2 upon 3. Okay. So we'll be solving this now. 0 plus minus. We will keep it inside the bracket, so it will be more convenient. Clear? Now, minus 23 plus 2 upon 3. So 0 plus minus 21 upon 3. So these 3 goes by 7. So 0 plus minus 7. Okay. 0 minus 7 is equal to minus 7. So what I did, after rearranging, I came here after solving the two brackets, the answer of the first bracket, that is the arrangement of minus 6 minus 5 upon 3, came to be minus 23 upon 3. And then the grouping of positive rational numbers I did, the answer came to be 2 upon 3. Then I have again rearranged them into a group, and then finally I got minus 7 of minus 7 as the solution of the entire bracket. And when I subtracted minus 7 from 0, ultimately my answer of this rearranging and solution, finding the solution, came to be minus 7. Now let's take the next question, that is, evaluate the following given rational numbers. So first of all, I am taking A1, that is minus 5 upon 8 minus 4 upon minus 7. Now here again, see everybody, the denominator has a negative sign.
Now, if the denominator has the negative sign, I cannot solve because you cannot find the LCM of a positive rational number and negative rational number. So, what are you supposed to do? You are first supposed to change the given rational number into its standard form. So, minus 5 upon 8 minus 4 upon 7. Okay. Now see, if this negative sign will be shifted to 4, how it will be shifted? Because you will be multiplying the numerator and the denominator by minus 1. So, this negative sign has been shifted to 4. Clear? Now, changing of sign will take place. Plus 4 upon 7 minus 5 upon 8 plus 4 upon 7. Let's take the LCM. LCM comes to be 56 minus 5 into 7 plus 4 into 8. Clear? It is 35 plus 32, right? Upon 56. So 5 minus 2 is 3 minus 3 upon 56 is the answer. Clear? Let's take the next question. So, the next part of the evaluate question is minus 3 minus 7 upon 9. So, in this again we will be taking the LCM of 1 and 9. Always remember, when there is no denominator with the rational number, it means the denominator is 1. This you have studied many a times, but you have to keep it in your mind that whenever there is no denominator, that means the denominator is 1. So, we take the LCM 9 minus 3 multiplied by 9. Why did I get 9? Because when 1 divides 9, we get 9 and 7 will be as it is, because 9 divided by 9 gives us 1. So, multiplied by 1. Now, minus 3 into 9 is minus 27, minus 7 upon 9. Now, these two will be added. 7 and 7, 14, 1 carry. It is minus 34 upon 9. So, this is the solution of the question. Now, let's take the next part. In the next part, see, it is minus 5 upon 9 minus 3 upon 4. Okay. Again, we will take the LCM of 9 and 4. It will come as 36. Minus 5 into 4 minus 3 into 9. So, minus 5 and 4 is how much? Minus 20. Minus 3 and 9 is 27 upon 36. So, it gives you minus 47 upon 36. So, this is how you have to be careful in finding out the evaluate kind of questions of the rational numbers. Now, let us take the other question. Because I will be needing more space, so, I am erasing question number 7 and 9 also. Okay, so let's go through the question first. Add the sum of 5 upon 9 and 6 upon 4 to the sum of 1 upon 2 and 4 upon 11. See, this question has been asked to you in two parts. First, you have to add and find out the sum of these two rational numbers. Then you will find the sum of these two rational numbers. And after finding the two sums, then you are supposed to add them. So, there are three calculations involved in this question. So, let's start. So, first required sum. Okay, the first required sum is 5 upon 9 plus 6 upon 4. On taking the LCM, again 36 will come.
right? 5 into 4 plus 6 into 9. 20 plus 54 upon 36 will give you what? 74 upon 36. Clear? Now, second required sum. Clear? Second required sum says 1 upon 2 plus 4 upon 11. Okay? 1 upon 2 plus 4 upon 11. So again we will solve. LCM comes to be 22. 1 into 11 plus 4 into 2. So it gives you 11 plus 8 upon 22. It is 19 upon 22. Now see, we have to find the sum of these two. Okay? So, I am again erasing the question so that I can get a proper space. Now, the sum of the two sums is equal to 74 upon 36 plus 19 upon 22. To avoid the confusion, we will use the long division method to find the LCM. Clear? 36 goes 18 times, 11 times. 9, 11. 3, 11. 1, 11. 11, 1, 1. Clear? Let's multiply. 2 2's are 4, 4 3's are 12, 12 3's are 36, 36 into 11. So 11 6's are 66, 6 carry, 11 3's are 33, 39. So what you have got? 396. Now, 396. Now, if you divide 36, if you divide 396 by 36, it goes 11 times, right? So 74 will be multiplied by 11 plus. Now you have to see that how many times 22 is dividing 39. 396. 22. 1's up, 22. 9 out of 2 is 7. 3 out of 2 is 1. And 6. So 18 times. Okay. Let's say 8 2's are 16, 1 carry, 8 2's are 16, 1, 17. So 18 times. Now 19 will be multiplied by 18. Clear? So this question has a little big calculation. So kindly do the calculation very vigilantly so that you do not make any mistake. Now see, 11 4s are 44, 4 carry, 11 7s are 77, 77 plus 4 gives you 81, 396 plus. Now, when you multiply 18 and 19, so what are you supposed to do? Multiplication, right? So 8 9's are 72, 7 carry, 8 1's are 8 and 7, 15, 1, 1, so 2, 5 and 9, 4, 5 and 9, 14, 1, 3, 42, how much? 342. 19 into 18 comes to be 342. So we will add these two. 396 will be the denominator. 814, 342. 4 and 2, 6. 1 and 4, 5. 8 and 3, 11. So it comes to be 1156. So this is the complete method which you are supposed to do to solve the following question. Now let's take the other question. In the next question, now we are supposed to perform the subtraction. Subtract the sum of 1 upon 3 and 6 upon 13. Now we will first find the sum. So first required sum is equal to 1 upon 3 plus 6 upon 13. Your LCM comes to be 39. 1 into 13 plus 6 into 3, 13 plus 6 threes are 18 upon 39. Here, what I have done, 1 upon 3 plus 6 upon 13 are my two rational numbers. 3 and 13's LCM is 39. After that, I equalize the numerator because when I divide 39 by 3, I get 13. So 1 multiplied by 13 gives you 13. When I divide 39 by 13, it goes 3 times. 6 threes are 18. So 8 and 3, 11. 1 carry 1, 2 and 3, 31 upon 39 is the required sum of the first condition. Then the required sum is 7 upon 9 plus 5 upon 6. This is the, you can write the statement also, second required sum. So it is 7 upon 9 plus 5 upon 6. So your LCM comes to be what? 18. Let's say 9 and 6. Okay, 2, 9 and 3, right? When it goes by 3, 3 and 3, 3 and 1, so again 1 and 1. So 2 3s are 6, 6 3s are 18 is your LCM, clear? Now 7 into 2 plus 6 into, 5 into 3. Here, 7 into 2 plus 5 into 3 upon 18. 14 plus 15 upon 18. 4 and 5, 9. 29 upon 18. So, after this, you have to subtract from the sum of this. So, this will be subtracted from it. So 29 upon 18 minus 31 upon 39. So this is the condition which we have to do. Now we will find the LCM of 18 and 39. So again we will be using the long division method of finding the LCM. 18, 39. So let's take 3. 6s are 13s are. Again, it goes by 3. 2s are 13s are. 2, 1, 13. 13, 1 and 1. Clear? Now let's multiply. 3, 3s are 9. 9, 2s are 18. 18 into 13. Okay? So, when I divide, when I multiply, 18, 3s are 54. 5 carry. Then 18 ones are 18 and 5 gives you 23. So the LCM comes to be 234. Clear? Now when you divide this 234 by 18, it goes 13 times. And when you divide this 234 by 39, let's see how many times does it goes. So 9, so I will take 39 into 6. 6 9s are 54, 5 carry. 6 3s are 18 and 5, 23. Okay, so it goes 6 times. 31 into 6. After this, I'll be carrying my calculation here. Now, let's multiply 29 and 13. You have to do the calculation very patiently because it has a little big calculation which could make some errors. So, to avoid the errors, be very vigilant in doing your calculation. So, 3 9s are 27, 2 carry, 3 2s are 6, 6 plus 2, 8, 9 and 2. So what do you get? 7, 8 and 9, 17, 1, 377. In the first case, you have got 377. Minus 3 1s, 6 1s are 6, 6 3s are 18. Upon 234. Do the subtraction. 377 minus 186. 7 out of 6, 1. 17 out of 8, 9. 2 out of 1, 1. So it is 191 upon 234. So basically, when you solve the word problems, you have to first note down that what has been asked in the question. Then only please put yourself forward in solving the questions. Now let's come to the next topic.